Good morning, students. Welcome to the third video. The Lake Isle of Innisfree is being discussed over here. This is from your book Beehive. It's a poem that has been included in chapter 4. It's written by William Butler Yeats and it describes how life amidst nature and simplicity is way better than the so-called or so perceived luxurious life of a city. Now, we'll come to the theme of the poem. Nature brings peace and harmony to man. That is the basic theme. The poet stresses on the fact that the closer you stay to the nature, the more peaceful you would be. The more artificial you become, the life would be more stressful. So he says, nature provides man with lovely sights and sounds, which pleases him and enables him to live a peaceful, stress-free life. Man should live close to nature. Poet himself wants to escape to the peaceful and beautiful place and build his dream home there. Although we are supposed to believe that the city is full of all the amenities, but all these amenities actually lead you to much more trouble, much more stress, if I put it that way. While living close to nature, your requirement becomes simple. Room made of clay and wattle is far more comfortable than the biggest or the costliest apartment rooms available in the cities, because what you get there is peace, which is priceless and which we can never expect in the hustle and bustle of a city. Now let's talk about the tone of the poem. It's very calm and relaxing tone. You see, it's a desire of a man. He is very calm and he has finally have everything and he just wants to settle down, be peaceful, be close to himself. That's the tone of the poem, very calm and relaxed. The reader may picture a person physically arising and living to this place, Innisfree. I arise and go now and go to Innisfree. See, the sound itself will make you think that poet is just about to get up and go while he saying all these things. However, instead of physically going to this place, the narrator is going to there with his mind. But practically, you can just, in the blink of an eye, you can't land from one place to another. So, although physically he is present in his very room, where he is disgusted, but somehow he finds solace in the fact that his mind has already reached Innisfree. So the place or all the lifestyle that he is thinking of is totally imagined by him in his head. It helps him to relax and escape the rush of modern living, right? When he thinks of spending life in Innisfree, he feels very relaxed, the way he feels while thinking about his future in the city. So here, Innisfree appears to be a state of mind than an actual place, particularly for the poet, because it's a state of mind, because it makes poet peaceful, feel happy. We call it fancies. This is a sort of fanciful thought that makes the poet happy. The moral values that we learn from this poem: we must appreciate nature as it has many benefits to offer us, obviously. So it's very clear, without nature, our life is full of stress. We must learn to be close to nature and enjoy its beauty. We must take time to be in places where we are able to find peace and quiet to make our life less stressful, harmonious and very meaningful. We should be proud of the natural heritage and preserve nature. And last but not the least, we should aspire less for the urban luxuries, rather than we should try and go back to the basic happiness of life, which is with nature. Now, the figurative language used in this poem, imagery of sight, that an image that is built in front of your eyes, a small cabin, bean rows, cricket sings, purple glow, linnet wings, lake water lapping, by the shore, roadway, pavements, these all create a visual image in your eyes. So this is an example of imagery of sight. You can draw a picture in front of your eyes. Well, there is imagery of hearing, when you can hear the sound actually while reading the poet. You feel like you can hear bees humming, or the singing of cricket, or the flapping of linnet's wings, or the water lapping on the shore, right? These shows, it creates an imagery. You will hear that word. The moment you read that, you notice the sound of water softly hitting the shore. It comes into your mind. Sound of cricket that we hear in the night, or sound of birds flapping their wings, or how bees hum together. The imagery of taste, honey, bean rose, they will give you imagery of taste, imagery of touch, clay, wattles, wail of the morning. We have all touched and felt them. So we feel like we are touching them. Then repetition, anaphor, I will arise and go now. This has been repeated. Many lines have been started through it. Then symbolizing. Innisfree symbolizes inner peace and freedom. Metaphor, evening full of linnet wings. This is not implied that the site is exactly full of linnet wings, but there were many birds flying around, right? There are my wails of the morning is another metaphor. Now synecdoche, I will arouse and go now and go to Innisfree. He's not physically getting up and going, but he's going in his mind, right? Then alliteration. Live, alone, be, loud, glade. Internal rhyme, dropping, morning, sings. There is this internal rhyme that takes place in the poem. Then the structure and style of the poem. The poem is written in 3 stanzas. Each stanza has 4 lines. The rhyme scheme of the poem is ABAB. The rhyme scheme creates a sense of harmony. It reflects that peace that the poet sees in the lake of Innisfree. So thank you for watching this. I'll be back with my next video. Till then, all of you take care, stay safe, and study hard. Goodbye.